One of my personal favorite ways to make money is with affiliate marketing. And every single time I talk about it in like my income reports or on the internet somewhere else, I always get bombarded with, how do I get started? How do I actually make money with it? What does that look like? Is there, you know, a pot of gold at the other end of all of this? And how do I do it? So today I want to talk about how to get started with affiliate marketing. So if you're sitting there saying, I want to do affiliate marketing, I want to make this kind of passive income, but I have no clue where to start, this is the video for you. What is up, y'all? Welcome back to my channel. If you are brand new here, my name is Jessica Stansberry, and I am here to help you make money so you can live the life you want to live. So if that sounds like something you are into, make sure you hit subscribe below so you don't miss any other tips and tricks with me every single week here on my channel. Okay, before we really get into like how to get started with affiliate marketing, let's talk about what affiliate marketing is and what it looks like from the perspective of the person who is participating in it, right? So affiliate marketing is essentially just, in its most basic form, making money for sending people to someone else's product. So you are like a middleman. You are gathering people who would want this thing that someone else sells, and you are sending them through to that person. And that person then pays you a commission based on the amount of people who purchase through your link or whatever. So affiliate marketing can be done in a ton of different ways. It can be done on a small scale, like, hey, my shirt is from Amazon, swipe up here on Instagram and go check it out, and I make 12 cents every time one of you purchases it. Or it can be done on a large scale where, you know, maybe you have a following of business owners, and then this person over here sells a $2,000 program, and you decide you want to promote their program to your audience, and you get a 50% commission for everyone sold. So that's a larger scaled version of affiliate marketing. But either way, the definition is that you make money from sending people to someone else's product. And from a marketing perspective, this is really smart, because one company cannot possibly gather all of the people in the world who want what they sell, right? Like, it's just not possible. So by having affiliates sprinkled out throughout the world, they can say, okay, well, that person has, you know, an audience that could send people our way. That person has this other audience that could send people our way. And it's also not industry specific. So you can do and take part in affiliate marketing regardless of the industry you're in, and make really good money regardless of the industry you're in. So I will say the place that most people start here is with sending people to products that they love, softwares that they love, etc., and making a small commission off of those things each month or with each sale. So for me personally, in my business, I've always made the most money when I promote a software. So things like ConvertKit or ClickUp, when I promote them and you sign up through my link, which, by the way, there's, I think sometimes people like get annoyed with other people promoting their affiliate links, but if you were going to sign up for it anyway, then you might as well sign up through someone's link. If you were going to buy something anyway, you might as well buy it through someone's link. It costs nothing to the purchaser to go through that middleman. It evens out the money along the way. Anyway, back to my point. So most people start with sharing products or services or softwares or whatever that they love. So when I promote ConvertKit, I make a small amount of money for each person that signs up based on how much of an account they signed up for. So if they're paying $30 a month, I'm gonna make a smaller amount than if they're paying $149 a month. Same thing with ClickUp. Now, the reason these two services are some of my favorites to promote is, one, I love them both, and I truly love them both, and I've used other softwares and promoted other softwares that I didn't make affiliate income from and I didn't love as much. So the fact that these companies have affiliate programs really makes me happy, because I really do love them and I make a little bit of money. But I will say those two are probably my favorite because they pay out on a monthly basis. So when someone signs up for ConvertKit or when someone signs up for ClickUp, I am not making a one-time fee. I am making a fee from that person every single month that they stay on the software. And those are my favorite kinds of things to promote. So in my business, softwares have always been the thing that makes me the most money with affiliate marketing, but it doesn't mean that's necessarily the only thing that I do. Oftentimes I will promote, like today I got on Instagram stories with this shirt on and someone was like, "Where did you get your shirt? I need to know." And it's from Amazon. So of course I was like, "Here's a swipe up if you guys want to go grab that." And you know, I will make very little money from that if someone does go grab the shirt from Amazon, but it's a little bit and it all adds up. So I definitely still do the other things, but softwares have been kind of a catalyst for me in the way that I personally use affiliate marketing. But you can use this in so many ways. Softwares, products, big companies like Amazon, Walmart. There are so many other examples and we're gonna talk about those in just a minute. Okay, so to get started, the number one thing you need to do is actually sign up to be an affiliate with what you wanna be an affiliate for. And there's several different ways to do this. You can actually sign up directly with companies. Some companies have direct affiliate marketing programs. Some companies don't have affiliate marketing programs, but you can affiliate for them through affiliate marketing services, and we'll talk about those in just a second. But there's several different ways to do this. So what I would do to get started is I would make a list of the top 10 things that you want to promote to your audience or to someone who finds you on the internet. So maybe you love a software, maybe you want to be a fashion blogger, maybe you want to be a beauty blogger or a home decor blogger, or you have a YouTube channel and you are promoting gardening supplies. Like this can be a full gamut of things. Maybe you are a business owner and you sell post-it notes, but you want to affiliate for pens or whatever, right? Like it can go down so many rabbit holes here, okay? So what I would do is make a list of the top 10 things that you want to promote, that you know that you use on a regular basis, that your audience will want to use as well. Then take off on the internet and go figure out how you affiliate for them. So again, some of them may be directly within the company. So when I was talking about ConvertKit or ClickUp, both of those things, you apply to be an affiliate directly from their websites, directly from ConvertKit.com, directly from ClickUp.com, okay? There are places like Walmart or Target that you can directly sign up to be an affiliate with them, okay? So it could be that there is a direct application straight from within the company. But there are also like third-party companies that are specifically made to be the middleman between the company and the affiliate. There's one called Share a Sale, and I will link all of this information below, but there's one called Share a Sale, and essentially that company has partnered with other companies to manage their affiliate relationships. So you can go through there, you can pick who you want to affiliate for, you can make a Share a Sale affiliate account, and then you can pick who you want to affiliate for and get approved and all of that within one thing. Some companies do have like follower number criteria or website traffic criteria or just other types of criteria that they follow before they approve affiliates. So I will say like applying to be an affiliate is not necessarily foolproof or something that guarantees that you can be an affiliate for something. But Share a Sale is one of those things, as well as an app called Like to Know It. So if you've ever followed any type of home decor blogger or specifically fashion blogger on Instagram, you know that this is the program that a lot of them use. And Like to Know It, or on the affiliate side where you manage your affiliate relationships, it's called Reward Style. This company essentially partners with home decor companies, fashion companies, all of these types of companies, and then will pay out commissions to their affiliates in that way. So, for example, when I was building my house, I shared a lot of the process on Instagram and a lot of the furniture choices and things like that. And when I would share furniture, people would be like, "Oh, do you have a link to that? Or can you tell me where to get that?" And I, of course, want to do that and I want to be the resource for people for that, but if I'm going to promote something anyway, I might as well be an affiliate for it, right? So I would go off to the company I'd bought the furniture from and I would see that they do not have an affiliate program set up, or they only partner with certain people, things like that. So what I would do is I would go to Like to Know It and see if I could find the products in their database. I got approved for a Like to Know It membership or affiliate account. And I do know there are audience size requirements for Reward Style style slash like to know it. But I was able to get approved for that. So then I would go in the database and I would find the furniture that I had purchased from another company, but they don't have an affiliate program, and I would link off to it with Like to Know It. So then Like to Know It would pay me for promoting that. So this is gonna take some research, but make a list of the places you wanna affiliate for and go see if they have a program. If they don't have a program, go see if something like Share a Sale or Like to Know It has a partnership with them where you can promote it through those apps. And remember that basically anywhere people shop online, you can probably affiliate for. So Amazon is probably the most popular one, and it is definitely one that shouldn't be ignored. Now, I do think of all the affiliate programs that I'm in, it pays out the least amount of money per sale, but it can, you know, it's worth it because it is where I get so much of my stuff that it's worth it for me to promote through Amazon instead of finding, you know, something on some random website that I normally would have bought through Amazon. So for instance, I only make about $100 a month, and there are some months when it goes up and down from Amazon because of people buying larger purchases or things like that. But for the most part, on average, I only make about $100 a month from Amazon, and I send over like thousands of clicks a month. So it's not necessarily the most lucrative way you can make affiliate income, but it's definitely one that shouldn't be ignored. And there's not a lot of requirements around getting approved either. There are some requirements around how to keep your account on Amazon. You have to sell so much in 60 days or whatever, but there's not really a lot of requirement around who you have to be or what kind of following you have to sign up for it. All right, so that was number one. You've got to figure out who you want to affiliate for, and you've got to figure out how to actually sign up to be an affiliate for that thing, okay? Number two, you have to start driving traffic to your affiliate links. Now, I'm not gonna be the person who sits here and tells you that everybody who's anybody can make a crap ton of money with affiliate marketing. I'm not gonna lie to you like that. We have a better relationship than that, okay? So let me be real with you here. The larger the audience you have, the more money you're gonna make from affiliate marketing. So if you have very small audience right now, if you have no audience, if you are just starting out, you are not going to see affiliate marketing sales because there's nobody in your audience to go purchase it. Now, that doesn't mean that you have to have a massive audience. It doesn't mean that you can't grow your audience along with your affiliate income. But again, I'm not gonna sit here and tell you that you can like not have any audience at all and make good money with affiliates, because that is not true. You don't have to have a massive audience, but you do need to have an audience. And the more your audience grows, the more money you will make. So you wanna start driving traffic to the affiliates that you wanna promote. And if you are just starting out, these ways to drive traffic that I'm gonna talk about are great ways to drive traffic regardless of whether you have a small audience or a large audience. But again, if you have a large audience, this is gonna work better for you, okay? So first and foremost, share the links to the things you're affiliating for on social media. Share them to your friends. Share them on your personal Facebook page. Those kind of things don't matter. You might have someone who's a friend of yours want to purchase something through your link rather than having to have this massive audience. But share it on social media. So for me, I share affiliate links a lot on Instagram with a swipe up. I will share affiliate links here on YouTube in my videos in the description box. I will share affiliate links on Facebook or Pinterest, okay? And even within my email marketing. So you can share these links wherever you want to. Now, I will say, asterisk here, you need to check with the terms and conditions of the company that you are representing, okay? Because a lot of times they do have terms and conditions on how you should promote, where you can promote, where you can't promote, etc. For example, if you are a regular Amazon affiliate, you cannot put Amazon affiliate links in your email marketing. I don't really know why, but you can't. So what you can do though, is you can link off to a page on your website from within your email marketing that has the links to your Amazon affiliate links, okay? Or if you have a larger following, you can get approved for the Amazon Influencer Program, which is a little bit different than the regular Amazon Associates Program. This allows you to build out a store straight on Amazon that you have a direct link to, and you can send people into that store. So again, this has social media requirements, following requirements. I don't think it's massive. I think if you have 1,000 or 2,000 followers somewhere, you could probably get approved, but I don't know that for sure. So with the Amazon Influencer program, you can include links to your Amazon Influencer store in email marketing. So everything's going to have different requirements and things like that. I will say that anytime you share an affiliate link, legally, you do have to disclose that there are affiliate links within the content. So, you know, if you're writing a blog post, you need to say at the bottom, there are affiliate links within this blog post. If you are putting them in the description of your YouTube videos, you need to say in that, in the description, there could be links to affiliates within this description. If you're putting them on Amazon, you need to tell people, like, I'm gonna make a commission when you swipe up. There's a fly driving me nuts in here. Okay, so you definitely want to get these links out into the world, and you know, the first way we're talking about is to share on social media. The second way is to incorporate the links in the content you're already creating. So, do you have a YouTube channel? Great. Put the links in your videos, in your description, whatever. Do you have a blog? Great. Put links in those blog posts. Are you creating content for Instagram or Facebook or LinkedIn or whatever? Great. Then incorporate those affiliate links in there. Maybe you're a podcaster and you want to start incorporating affiliate links into your episodes. You can use them as ads or whatever. So for instance, on my podcast, which if you're not listening to, is called Grit, and you can find it on any podcast player, but on my podcast, I don't have actual sponsors for the podcast. What I do have are two ads running to two different affiliate programs that I am a part of. So I have an ad running to Audible, and I have an ad running to ConvertKit. So while I don't have an actual sponsor for the podcast, I am making money from the podcast because people are hearing those ads and going through my link to sign up for Audible or ConvertKit. So you can incorporate affiliate links into whatever content you're already creating. Another option is to run ads to specific affiliate links. Now, again, check with the company you're affiliating for because they may have rules and restrictions around this, but you could run ads to the perfect person who would want to sign up for this thing, right? And then include your affiliate link for them to sign up through. So, you know, okay, I want you to sign up for this program or this software, or I want you to buy this shirt, or this company is really awesome. I'm gonna run ads to this to tell you how awesome it is. And when you click through to purchase, you're purchasing through my affiliate link. So you can absolutely do that if the affiliate relationship allows for that to be done. And I mentioned this one a second ago, but I just wanna give it its own little time in the spotlight, and that is to use your affiliates as ads within your content. So not only, you know, might you write a blog post all about something and incorporate an affiliate link where it makes sense, not only might you mention something in a YouTube video or on a podcast episode and incorporate the link to that when it makes sense, but you might create ads to go within your content to send people to your affiliate relationships. So, you know, like I said, on my podcast, I send people via ads that run in the podcast to Audible and ConvertKit. Maybe I wanted to create a YouTube video and use ConvertKit as a sponsor for my YouTube video. I can create an entire ad that goes in the middle of this video that sends people over to ConvertKit through my link. So you can kind of go about this in a really creative way. It doesn't always just have to be, you know, throwing affiliate links around. What I will say though is that people appreciate organic shares. And if you are affiliating for things that you don't actually use, or you are telling people to go purchase things that you don't actually believe in, or you're running ads for things that your audience doesn't care about or whatever, you're not going to make near the money from affiliate marketing you would if you are organically saying, I love this thing, go sign up for it, or I love this thing, here's an affiliate link, or whatever, okay? So that's where incorporating links into your content when they make sense is going to be massively amazing for you and your affiliate relationships, because people will feel the genuineness of that and not feel like it's being forced or pushed on them. So like I said a second ago, it can be really hard to make any money from affiliate marketing if you have no or a very, very small following. But here's the thing, you can start incorporating affiliates now, even when you have that small following. And once your following grows, those affiliate links and the clicks that happen on them will grow, and the money you make from that will grow. So while it may not be the most lucrative option for you if you don't have a big audience, it can be a really great way to go ahead and start incorporating those things in. So maybe you have a blog post or a YouTube video or a podcast episode go viral, and now thousands of people are listening and you have an affiliate link in it. That could be amazing, right? And you may have thought, well, I don't need to bother putting affiliate links because nobody listens or reads or watches my stuff. But you never know when that could change. So I would start incorporating affiliate links now, even if you do have a small audience. And then if you have a large audience, it's a great way to kind of infuse more income into whatever you're doing, whether you're a content creator, whether you sell products, whatever, you can incorporate affiliate income into that really, really, really easily. Okay, so I do have a few more videos on affiliate marketing that I have done before on this channel. So I will link those below. So if you want to watch more about that and really learn more, you can do that. But honestly, the biggest thing to do now that you finish this video, is to go make that list of the people you want to be an affiliate for and go figure out how to sign up for their affiliate programs and start sharing the links. It's as easy as that. Now, if you have any questions about affiliate marketing or want me to expound on anything I talked about in this video, definitely let me know in the comments below so that I can create more videos that are helpful for you if you have those questions. And until next time, make sure you hit subscribe so you don't miss any other videos here from Hey Jessica. Bye, y'all.